Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to make a phone call with one tap on your iPhone or one click on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to its community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So what if you want to have as few steps as possible to call important people, either on your phone or using FaceTime on your Mac? Usually there are a few steps involved, unless you want to use Siri. But you can actually create an icon on your phone or on your Mac that with just one action will make that call. Alright, so on the iPhone you could probably guess that I'm going to use the Shortcuts app. If you don't have it, you can get it for free from Apple in the App Store. So you go into Shortcuts here and I'm going to create a new shortcut, and it's going to be a fairly simple one. First thing I want to do is grab the phone number for my contacts. So I'm going to search for an action involving contacts. Contacts is the one I want, and I can hit the plus button there and search for a contact. Then I select the contact. So that'll grab the contact. Next thing I want to do is grab the phone number from the contact. So I'm going to search for phone. I'm going to use get phone numbers from input. That'll grab the phone numbers from that contact. If there's more than one phone number in there though, it's going to give me an extra step. I'll show you how to avoid that. The last part I want to add is call. So you'll notice it gives you some suggestions here. You can use these suggestions to avoid this entire thing and just have this as one action. But if you don't see the suggestion you want, you're going to have to do these steps. So I'm going to use the call action. Now I want to go to settings and I want to give this a good name. Hit done. I'm going to go to the icon and I can go to glyph, and I can actually use, say, a telephone glyph. But I could also go and select a photo. So I can take a photo of that person and use that as the icon. I can set the color as well. Hit done, and then I can use add to home screen to add a button, and that button will basically make that phone call with one tap. Now instead of using contacts and get phone numbers from input, I can do something else. I could use one called phone number, and then that allows me to actually enter in the number. I want to move that before call and enter in the phone number. And now it'll just simply call that number. This helps if you have more than one phone number for a contact. It'll still do it in one step if you provide the actual phone number. Okay, so that's pretty easy to do on the iPhone. On the Mac it's a little harder. We're going to use Automator, but we're actually not going to use any Automator actions at all. We're going to use a shell script, just one line to make the call, and then we're going to use a little bit of JavaScript code to make it one click. So let's bring up Automator. I'm going to search for it using Spotlight and run it, and then I'm going to create a new document and let's make that an application. First thing I want to add is a shell script. So I'm going to search for shell over here on the left and then add run shell script. The shell script I want to run is just something that's going to actually trigger a phone call using the FaceTime app. So you can see all I need is open FaceTime :// and then the phone number there. And that will actually open FaceTime and make the phone call. Go and hit the run button here and it runs FaceTime, and you can see it puts the phone number up there, and then it has the call button, but it says click FaceTime to make this call. So I have to do another step. So now the key is, can I get rid of that second step? And I can using a bit of JavaScript. So I'm going to search for JavaScript here and add run JavaScript as the next action. Now what I want to add here is just something that's basically going to click that call button. So the first line of code is just going to activate FaceTime. So it's going to make sure that FaceTime is the running app. The next line of code is going to click that button. It's basically going to go application system events, then look for the application processes, grab by name the one called FaceTime, look at all the windows in it and grab the window by name that is FaceTime, look at all the buttons in it, grab the button by name named call, and then perform a click action on it. How did I get all this? A lot of trial and error. I knew I needed to do this to get the application processes. I was able to list them all out and get FaceTime as the name. Then I was able to look at the windows and then find that FaceTime was the name of that window. A little trial and error there. Then look at all the buttons and then look at each button's name and find out that the second button was call. The first one was cancel, and then say click. So what's going to happen now is this thing will run and it will click that button. Let's try it. So you can see there it made the phone call. Now you may at this point get asked to give permission to Automator to do this, and it will open up system preferences. We'll look at that more a little bit later. because it's definitely going to ask for those permissions once you create the app. Now all I need to do is save this out. I could save it, say to the desktop, name it something like Call John there, save it as an application. Now I can look on the desktop and see that it's there. I can change the icon the standard way you do on a Mac. When I run it there the first time, it is going to ask me if I want this to control system events. I will say OK. I'll then have to go into System Preferences. And in System Preferences, it's going to jump right here to Accessibility. I can unlock this, then look for this Call John script that I set up here. Then I can run it and it will press the button. Now you can put this application in a folder, in your Documents folder, maybe with a bunch of other similar ones to make phone calls. And once you have it there, you can always add it to the dock as well. And you can call right from the dock with one click. Now for this to work on your Mac, you either need to be making a FaceTime call to somebody with an Apple ID, or you need to have your Mac and your iPhone set up so your Mac can use your iPhone to make phone calls. In this case, I don't have that because this is a demo user account. It's not hooked up to an iPhone, but it will work on a regular account. This is really handy for someone that makes lots of phone calls to the same people all the time and wants to quickly be able to make those phone calls with one tap or one click.